हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू लेट्स डिस्कवर इट। दिस इज आर्या एंड टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द नोट्स ऑफ चैप्टर 3 कंबशन एंड फ्लेम। ओके, सो बिगिन विथ दिस वीडियो बिकॉज आई हैव कंप्लीट ऑल थ्योरम ऑफ दिस वीडियो एंड आई हैव कंप्लीट द समरी ऑल्सो। सो अ केमिकल प्रोसेस इन विच अ सब्सटेंस रिएक्ट विथ ऑक्सीजन टू गिव ऑफ हीट इज कॉल्ड कंबशन। ओके, आई हैव टोल्ड इन थ्योरी वीडियो ऑल्सो। द लोएस्ट टेम्परेचर एट विच अ सब्सटेंस कैच फायर इज कॉल्ड इट्स इग्निशन टेम्परेचर। अ मिक्सचर ऑफ एंटनिमी ट्राइसल्फाइट पोटेशियम क्लोरेट एंड वाइट फॉस्फोरस विथ सम ग्लू एंड स्टार्च वॉज अप्लाइड ऑन द हेड ऑफ मैच मेड ऑफ सुटेबल लूड। वेन स्ट्रक अगेंस्ट अ रफ सर्फेस वाइट फॉस्फोरस गॉट इग्नाइट ड्यू टू हीट एंड हीट ऑफ फ्रिक्शन। दीज डेज द हेड ऑफ द सेफ्टी मैच कॉन्टेन ओनली एंटीमनी ट्राइसल्फाइट एंड पोटेशियम क्लोरेट। द रविंग सर्फेस हैज पाउडरी ग्लास एंड लिटिल रेड फॉस्फोरस। फॉस्फोरस इज अ वेरी रिएक्टिव नॉन मेटल substance which have very low ignition temperature and can easily catch fire with a flame are called inflammable substance. A fire involving electric equipments and inflammable material like petrol, carbon dioxide is the best CO2 is the best extinguisher, being heavier than oxygen cover the fire like a blanket. Since the contact between the fuel and the oxygen is cut off, the fire is controlled. Okay, the combustion in which the gas burn rapidly and produce heat and light is called rapid combustion. The combustion reaction which occur without the help of any external heat is called spontaneous combustion. A large amount of gas formed in the reaction, such reaction is called explosion. You have to remember these definitions because these are not given in your book, that the combustion in which the gas burns rapidly and produce heat and light is called rapid combustion. The combustion reaction which occur without any help of external heat is called spontaneous combustion. And the large amount of heat, you can say a large amount of gas form in the reaction, such reaction is called explosion. Okay, the substance which vaporizes during burning gas gives flame. I have told you in theory video also that those substance which vaporize during burning gives flame. Okay, for example, kerosene oil and molten wax rise through wick end are vaporized during and form flame. Charcoal on the other hand does not vaporize and so does not produce a flame. Okay, yeah. The next point is the amount of heat energy produced on complete combustion of 1 kg of a fuel is called its calorific value. This is very important. This could be asked in your exam, so please remember that. The calorific value of a fuel is expressed in a unit called kg. Kg means kilogram and kg means kilo joule. Okay, calorific value of some important fuels are given below. You have to remember that. First is cow dung, which is 6,000 to 8,000. Wood is 17,000 to 22,000. Coal is 25,000 to 33,000. Petrol is 45. Diesel is also 45,000. Kerosene is also 45,000. Methane is 50,000. CNG is 50,000. LP is 55,000. And biogas is 35,000 to 40,000. And the highest point is 150,000 hydrogen. Okay. Nowadays, hydrogen and carbon came. Okay, the increased fuel consumption has harmful effect on the environment. Yes, first is कार्बन फ्यूल लाइक वुड कोल पेट्रोलियम रिलीज अनबर्नड कार्बन पार्टिकल्स इन आवर एनवायरनमेंट दीज फाइन पार्टिकल्स आर डेंजरस पॉल्यूटेंट काउजिंग रेस्पिरेटरी डिजीज लाइक अस्थमा या अस्थमा ओके सो इन कंप्लीट कंबशन ऑफ दीज फ्यूल गिव्स कार्बन मोनोक्साइड गैस इट इज़ वेरी पॉइजनस गैस Combustion of most fuel release carbon dioxide in the environment and increasing the concentration of carbon dioxide in the environment, it is believed to cause global warming. Burning the coal and diesel release sulfur dioxide gas, SO2. It is extremely suffocated and corrosive gas. Moreover, petrol engine give off gaseous oxide of nitrogen, oxide of sulfur and nitrogen dissolve in rain water and produce acid, due to which on earth acid rain has happened. It is very harmful for crop, building and soil. What is the global warming? Okay, this is a you can say a main topic of this chapter is global warming. Global warming is the rise in temperature of the atmosphere of the earth. This result among other things in the melting of the polar glacier, which lead to rise in sea level and causing flood in coastal areas. Low-lying wetland area may even be permanently submerged under the water. It will be happened if global warming happen. So this video will be completed. We will meet in other video with next chapter. From this side, Arya. If you like the video, please tap the like button. Do subscribe my channel and press the bell icon also to get the notifications of recent videos. From this side, Arya. Thanks all of you.